If you've seen the new movie Joker, you probably saw him carrying a card which says, "Forgive my laughter, I have a condition." And like me, you probably wondered, is there a real condition which can cause that? Short answer is yes. It's called pathological laughter and crying. And it's defined as patients that exhibit exaggerated or inappropriate episodes of laughter without an apparent motivating stimulus, or in response to stimuli that would not have elicited such a response in normal conditions. Which simply means laughing without an apparent cause or laughing too hard to something which isn't that funny. Pathological laughter is a symptom which can be associated with various neurological disorders, such as stroke, Parkinson's, multiple sclerosis, and dementia. And remember that ice bucket challenge that was supposed to raise funds for ALS? Well, researchers found that 49% of ALS patients had episodes of pathological crying or laughing. But in the movie, the Joker had this condition due to his abusive childhood. So, can trauma cause pathological laughter? A study conducted in 1996 on 13 patients who suffered severe trauma to the head found that pathological laughing occurred in 6 patients, pathological crying in 2 patients, and both laughing and crying in 8 patients. So yes, it is possible. But what causes it? In the 19th century, researchers thought that emotions are generated in a specific part in the brain due to a process of excitation and inhibition, meaning that this part has a process which is responsible of amping up specific emotions, like laughing, and a separate process which is responsible of stopping those emotions. It was assumed that people who suffered from pathological laughter had a damaged inhibitory process and can't stop laughing. But later on, it became clear that the process of generating emotions is much more complex than that and requires multiple parts of the brain to generate. We don't know what exactly causes pathological laughing, but we do know that medications that are designed for depression and mood disorders work really well for pathological laughing using a much lower dosage,